This conference will now be recorded.
Hi and hello everyone, welcome to Asia Training Solutions. So today what we are going to do, we are going to pretty much start the content. Yesterday I gave the brief about like what are all the course content that we are going to cover as part of this course journey. Today we will straight away start the course content and then we'll see a little about Datadog activities maybe. Okay, so so first I'll start the content and then we'll go into Datadog visualization. So first topic is actually what are APM tools. Already I know you guys are pretty much aware of what is APM tool. Okay, those who are literally coming to this new concept, for the benefit of those people, APM is nothing but like application performance monitoring tool. Okay, application performance monitoring tool. In certain cases, they are calling that as application performance management tool as well. Okay, monitoring tool or management tool, because monitoring tool only does the capture of the metric. Okay, management tool only will do the managing of certain activity. Because nowadays all these APM tools are designed in such a way, it can also do some managing activity, alerting, or you want to do certain activity, that is still possible using these APM tool, that is still possible. So it is something that it is not only doing the monitoring activity, it is also doing a management activity. That is the reason in certain cases they'll say application performance management. Okay, so now we may have this question. Okay, what way you are using this APM tool? Why we are not using the other tools like your utility tools or your profiling tools? Why not those tools? Why you are using this tool? That is the primary ask from everybody. Okay, so this utility tools, or the utility tools will give you certain information about your heap, thread, garbage collection, like that. There are certain information will be there for the utility tool. And for profiling tool, it will provide the same heap, thread, garbage collection, but you can also go till the source code. Till the source code level, you can go and do the activity. In the case of profiling tool. But this APM tool, you know, it is like all rounder, like it is like all in one. You can get all the information. Okay, you can get what you are getting it in your utility tool, you can get what you are getting it in the profiling tool, but not to the source code level. But I'm saying you can get more info when compared to your profiling tool. And if you are trying to use like single user performance testing tools like GT metrics or web page test or Lighthouse or dev tools, like that you are using different tools, right? Instead of it, you can use this APM tool. So in a nutshell, if you say what these APM tools are doing, means it is actually doing all. It is doing infrastructure monitoring, it is doing application monitoring, it is performing database monitoring, it is performing real user monitoring, it is performing synthetic monitoring, like that. All in all, it is actually performing, and it is a user friendly tool as well. APM tools are user friendly tools, and you do not require a extensive coding knowledge and all, because all these are out of the box features. Out of the box features. Okay, you are going to click, drag, drop. That's all. That's how you will be using these tools. But to an extent, to a maximum level, you can identify your performance bottleneck. That's the best benefit of these tools. Okay, in that way only APM tools are really, really useful. Okay, so we know what these APM tools are actually doing. All the APM tools in the industry, all the APM tools in the industry, how it is actually working? It is working in the concept called agent. Okay, a small software, a piece of software. Agent will be installed into the respective places. If you wanted to monitor web server, if you wanted to monitor app server, if you wanted to monitor DB server, if you want to try to monitor your browser level data, wherever, whichever data that you wanted to get it, you need to have agents. The agents is a piece of software which is actually collecting the data, and those data is actually send it to your respective APM tool. That is a logic. That's the APM tool logic. All the APM tools are working in the concept called agents. Okay, agents. So through that only you are going to get the data. These agents will collect the data. Each tool will have their own way of agent installation, their own way of doing the consolidated data collection. Because why I'm saying the word consolidated, in Dynatrace, that's called as one agent. One agent fits for all. Similarly, here also you can install on the host level. In AppDynamics, it is on the technology level. In CA APM also, it is on the technology level like that. So each and every, even Neuralink is the same technology level. So each and every tools are designed in such a way, whatever you wanted to monitor, you are going to install one agent, one particular piece of software into the respective infrastructure. And that agent should not have any problem, because everybody will have the mind block. What is that mind block? If I say install the agent, means they'll say I installed the agent, even then it is not reporting data. No, you should have the proper procedure. What is that procedure? Proper firewall exceptions, proper port exceptions, proper proxy exceptions, all those should be available, because it is communication between one network to the another network, right? This data dog is in one network and your organization is there in another network. So you need to have the proper communication between these two networks, which means that a proper proxy, proper firewall, proper port exceptions, all those should be there. Then only the communication between the entity will happen, between the entity. That is a protocol, right? So you need to have the proper communication. Then it has to be properly, we receive the exceptions. Once that is actually done, the communication exceptions that are done, and then when you are installing these agents, it will collect the data. The agents are collecting the data and it will send the data back to your data dog, or not only data dog, all the respective APM tools. And then the remaining activity, it is up to your analytical thinking, analytical analysis, how you are going to do the investigation. When your disk utilization metrics are received, or CPU utilization metrics are received, or memory utilization metrics are received, or your error related metrics are received, your response time related metrics are received. So it is up to you, because data collection will be done by the agents and it is sending the data back to your UI. And how you are going to really perform that investigation. That is the main activity. So all the way, it is your analytical way in which you are going to do the investigation. So you are going to have that understanding. What is that understanding? Whichever the layer that I'm going to monitor, each and every layer that I'm going to monitor, that I will first note it down. Okay, I'll note, okay, these are the things that I'm going to monitor, these are the technology that I'm going to monitor, like that. We have to list it out. And then based on that, you need to have the respective agent should be available in respective places. Once that is actually available and the data will be collected and it is sent back to your APM tool, means the remaining all your investigations only. Okay, so with respect to the data dog, if you ask me, you know, our data dog is having the integration with Jira, it is having the integration with PagerDuty, it is having the integration with Slack, even you can send a simple email also. So multiple things are there, right? This is the place you are calling this as a management tool. Instead of a monitoring tool, you are calling it as a management tool. Because you are managing something, you are alerting someone, you are informing someone, you are making others to get into that problem statement and ask them to do some resolution. So these are something that kind of a management activity that you are trying to perform, So in that way only we are trying to use this APM tools. APM tools are, this is the way. You are going to install the agent, the agents are sending the data, and you are going to utilize for that. Okay, I'll take a pause here. Anybody have any question till now, you can ask your question.
I think it's clear so far, Saranan.
Yeah,
Sandeep, this here I have a question. You told me like we have to install the agent, okay, for the specific system or where or a specific client. Like if I'm using my own laptop, if I'm using my own laptop to just develop, just getting the, all the application performance of the any particular application, okay, and I just install the agent in my laptop. So in this case, that in this case, agent should accept all the things which I'm doing in my laptop. Is it correct?
What you are doing? Is it a infrastructure monitoring or application level? Okay, is it infrastructure level?
Application level.
Yeah, application level means the application that are running in your machine, corresponding agent should be there. Then only it works.
Okay, so in this case, like if I'm opening a website like Amazon.com, and I just need to check the all the things of the all the metrics related to the performance monitoring of that particular application. Now, in background, my Outlook, my Skype is also running. So, is it possible for the AppDynamics, like AppDynamics, also create the script or also capture the code for that particular thing?
This is not AppDynamics. Sorry, this is Datadog tool. So, say each and everything, there is a separate procedure that is available. If you are trying to do what is happening in your browser, there is a real user monitoring that is available. Okay. And if you are trying to do something that you are, I hope everybody able to see this thing. Okay. This is a tool.
Right.
Okay. So, if you are trying to do real user monitoring, browser level activities would be coming. Or if you wanted to do any particular thing that you wanted to particularly monitor it. Okay, any software package. Okay, I mean to say your technology. You take in that way. With the technology that you wanted to monitor, that is also respectively you have to perform. But you answer to your question, it may be in your laptop. Yeah, still it is possible. It is not like server class only you have to do it. No, in your laptop you can see. I think you are able to see the technology supported screen, right? So all these are something that you can do it. All these are available based on your need, what you are really going to do, what you are going to really integrate with, whether it is a Java, whether it is a .NET, whether it is a Node.js, what you are really trying to monitor, that corresponding configuration you have to perform. That is what I told yesterday's session also. Datadog.yaml file will be there. There is a YAML file, which is a controller file, okay? That file and this your integration, if you are doing it properly, then whatever you are trying to monitor, you can still do it, Sandeep. You're able to understand.
Yeah, got it. Yes, because yesterday I just missed the sessions. I just started from today.
Okay.
I need to go to the previous video. Thank you.
Yes. Yeah. But don't worry, we did not have much of a discussion yesterday. We only discussed only the course content. But I'm saying whenever you are trying to do certain things, you need to do the configuration accordingly, and then you have to monitor it. But I'll show you. There is a infrastructure monitoring is there. Okay, infrastructure means your host level monitoring that you are trying to do. Right now, what happened? I installed this particular Datadog agent into my Amazon Linux environment. This is right now. I'm showing you a console, right? This is PuTTY. Okay, PuTTY console I'm showing, right? This is actually my Linux machine, Amazon Linux machine. In that, probably, just a minute, I'll try to show you whatever. Yeah, this green color, I hope you're able to see this. This is actually installed the Datadog agent, okay? Once you're successfully installing this Datadog agent, and if you go to Datadog, there you will see the host. This is a host. Okay, this is a host. If I click on that, it will show me like this is a Linux machine and all your infrastructure information, you can validate it. This is the first step. Okay, once you wanted to get only the infrastructure level data, that is one step. Along with that, on top of it, is there anything something you wanted to monitor? You need to do the changes or you need to do the procedure accordingly. You are getting me point, Sandeep?
Right. Thank you. I got it.
So guys, I'll repeat one more time. Today I did not explain anything that what has to be done on Datadog, which technology, what you are doing, how you are doing that and all. Today, as per the topic, anyways, I'm going to go with the flow only. This is a flow. this is a flow based on the course content only we are going to cover it, but I wanted to show you how Datadog will be there, because sometimes the learner's mindset is like that. Those who are attending these demo sessions are, you know, the learner's mindset is it is a pure theoretical session or what. Are they not showing any can we get installation also for Datadog on cloud machines? Yeah, still we can do it. Yes, Pravit, we can do it. I did it in the cloud only, right? This is Amazon cloud only. Yeah, coming back, so the learner's mindset should not be like this, right? Like this guy will only cover it everything theoretically, he will never show the tool at all. No, this course journey is actually a practical oriented course journey. What we are really trying to do is that, like, we wanted to bring that the practical experience with you people. So going forward, somebody is asking you a question that you have exposure or you have experience in working with this Datadog tool, you should get that confidence. In that way only we are going to have this entire course journey designed. So we'll try to do everything practical. In tomorrow session we will see in that way only. In tomorrow session we are going to create the account, and then you are going to set it up, the agent, and one by one, like if I set Windows server monitoring or if I set Linux server monitoring, like that only we are going to do from tomorrow. So the context is that, like, you, this is the SaaS version of your Datadog account, and which I created. So tomorrow I'll explain, like, how to do these things and all. Once you are done with this creation of the account, we will go one by one, the core capability and the core functionality of Datadog, and how you are going to do the configuration for each and everything, we are going to see subsequently. The intent is like that. Okay, so coming back, if I say in Datadog, the internal components, okay, I'll try to see is there anything available, or else I'll type it. Okay, Datadog. Or else no problem. I'll simply write down this, no problem. So supervisor D. Okay, this is the one component inside the architecture of your Datadog, supervisor D. Okay, which is manager to everything. Whatever is actually happening, it manages everything. Okay, supervisor D is the one which is managing all the activities, supervisor D. And there is one more component called collector. So from the name itself, it is clearly evident it is going to gather all the metrics. It is going to gather all the metrics. And Dodge stats D. Okay. Dodge stats D. It is going to aggregate all the report. All the metrics. It is going to aggregate all the metrics. Okay, and then there is a one more thing called forwarder. So it is clearly evident forwarder is nothing but it sends the information to your Datadog in cloud. Okay, it sends the information to Datadog in cloud. So these are the components. Okay, these are, you can take this as an architecture or whatever, but internally in Datadog, these are the components that are the supervisor D, collector, docstats D, and then forwarder. Okay, these are each and every active supervisor. From the name supervisor D, it manages everything. Collector, it collects the data. Docstats D aggregates the data. Forwarder sends the data. This is how your entire internal components of your Datadog is actually there. Okay, so coming back to our course content. Why APM tools are required to be learned by the DevOps engineers, performance testers, or performance engineers? Okay, so APM tools. If I ask, if I send, say, developer. Okay, developer, when they are doing a unit testing. Okay, I'll ask this question in the forum also. When the developer is actually doing a development activity, in order to find the performance bottleneck, what are all the maximum things that they will do, guys? Anybody can, you give a random guess, okay? You tell me what are all the activities developers will usually do to find the performance bottleneck. Anybody can say. What they can really do, they can do unit testing. While doing the unit testing, what they will do, they will do profiling, they will do single user performance testing, or they can do automation tools or something like that. They can do even utility tools, all those things they can do. But if the developers are using the APM tools, you know, it is really, really easy for them to identify the issues. It is really easy. Because if I say like the developer developing a code, and then it is reaching to the integration testing, it is reaching to the performance testing, and it is reaching to the production, there is a problem. There is a problem in the production. If you go back and ask the developer why you missed this issue, why you are not finding in your early stage itself, how it is actually missed, like that, if I really seriously asking this question to the developer, what they will answer, guys? Generally, what they will answer? Generally, what they will answer, they'll say, no, I don't have any time. I do not have any time to do all these kind of a thorough testing. The sprint cycle is only 2 weeks or 3 weeks only. You, the user stories are heavy. Lot of defects are coming. Lot of environmental dependency that are happening. I don't find any time. Like that only they will tell all the reasons, right? The developer will say that. They do not find time to identify the issue because of the timeline pressure. So obviously, if the developers are trying to use these kind of APM tool, it is easy. They do not really require to spend a lot of time to identify the issue. They can find the CPU issue, memory issue, disk issue, all the kind of issue. Only thing is the initial environment setup alone they have to do, and the rest all will APM tool will take care of it. So in that case, to do a detailed unit testing, this kind of APM tool will be really, really useful. These APM tools will be really useful for the developers in order to do a very detailed unit testing. Detailed unit testing. And then performance testers. Performance testers. So in this forum, definitely a lot of performance testers will be there. You tell me, if I ask you a question, search transaction is actually taking 14 seconds. A search transaction is actually taking 14 seconds. 14 seconds. So if I ask you a question, where that particular 14 seconds is actually taking, what is the answer? Anybody can say. How will you do? How will you do the analysis?
The initial thing is like we can do a single user test and start our analysis from there.
Okay, no. We'll go one step before. I asked a question that where that 14 second is actually spent. No, you are saying the recovery process. I'm saying if I ask you the question, this question, where that 14 seconds is actually spent, you tell me usually what is your output. The usual Answer is you do not have any source. Your performance testing tools will not give you that kind of a detailed information. Your tool will give you start transaction, end transaction, what is the transaction response time. That is the maximum level you can get it in the performance testing tools. You cannot go very detailed information and all. Okay. So what is that meaning? So the performance tester require some other tool. Okay. The performance tester require some other tool to identify where the actual time spent. It may be application layer, it may be database layer, it may be network layer, whatever. But you need to have that detailed information, layer by layer, tier by tier information should be there. So for those activities, okay, layer by layer data, okay, for those information you need to have these APM. Okay, you need these APM tools. So for performance testers also, these APM tools are really, really, really important, because your performance testing tools are not giving this kind of a detailed information. We will not get it, correct or not? Your performance testing tool will not give you the client side response time. Your performance testing time will give you first visual change, onload time, full load time, or your large contentful paint, first contentful paint, all those things your performance testing tool will give you. Anybody can say? No, not at all. Your performance testing tool will only give you the server level time spent, because the communication is actually happening in HTTP layer, transport layer only the communication is actually happening. Okay. If it is happening in the presentation layer only, you can do a client side response time and all. So the objective is, in order to get a very detailed information, layer by layer, tier by tier information, if you wanted to get it, you need APM tools. Okay, it is not that easy to get those information using a plain vanilla performance testing tool. Performance testing tool will not give that. Correct or not? Anybody have difference of opinion in that? Performance testing tool will give you all the split up or your client side response time, all those things your performance testing tool will give you. So I quickly go to this website. Okay, so simple example I'm showing you. This is actually Isha Make It Easy. There is one image there, right? Right click, copy image address, and then I'm putting it in the browser, click enter. Okay, what is happening here? I copied that image address and I launched it. The image is actually loading where? Where it is actually loading? It is loading in the center of your page, but actually in a real page that is there in the left corner. That too, the size is very small. So now you imagine, guys, when you are trying to do a performance testing tool, what it will do, it will capture each and every static URL as a static content as a URL. Every PNG file, JPEG file, all the static content it will capture as a URL. And when you are trying to replay the script, what will happen? All those URLs are actually called, but your tool will not say that the URL is coming in left hand side, right hand side, center, bottom, top. No, nothing, no information will be there. So your page painting, page rendering, onload time, full load time, all those information your performance testing tool cannot determine, because your performance testing tools only captures the URL. It will only paste the URL, which means that it will be loading like this. It is literally loading like this. Your tool is not having the intelligence built in to identify, is there an image that is actually in what size, what x axis, what y axis, where it has to come. All those intelligence will not be there for your performance testing tool. Okay, so that is the reason I'm saying your client side response time through the performance testing tool, it is hard to find it. But your APM tools will help the performance tester to identify how much of a time it is taken for each and every content to be loaded onto the browser. So real user monitoring is still possible. real user monitoring is still possible. I hope everybody is clear with this. Anybody have any question in this? You can ask your question, please. I think we are good with what we are covering. With that assumption, I'll move to the next one. Similarly, for performance engineers also, this tool will be really, really useful, because anyways, performance engineer job is finding the optimized way in which your application should work. Okay, in what way you are going to make your application fine tune, optimize, compress, all those things you are going to do, right? So definitely this APM tool will be really useful for the performance engineers to fine tune the application performance. Okay. Fine tune the application performance. And for system support engineers, yes, true. Traditionally, my friends who are working in system support team, you know, they usually sit, traditionally I'm saying, they usually sit in front of the machine for 24/7. They will observe the servers, what is happening in the servers, and they'll say like, is there any problem in so and so server? They'll invite the respective team member to fix the issue. It may be in midnight, it may be in early morning, but their job is to do that, and then they will make the application working. They'll make the application up and running without any problem. That was the case. That was the case with a system support engineer. They'll create level 1 ticket, level 2 ticket, level 3 ticket. Like that, they'll create a ticket and they'll work on it and they'll make the servers up and running. Okay, that's the job of them, right? Now, because of these APM tools are into the picture, the job is a little easy, right? Because you do not require to sit in front of the machine. You only require to configure the alerts. You require to configure the alerts based on your CPU, based on your memory, based on your disk. You are going to configure the alerts threshold. Once the threshold is actually breached, your alerting will be coming to you. Instead of you do the job, the tool will do the job. That's the best benefit of using this APM tools. This APM tools, in that way only it is used for, it is useful for developers, DevOps engineers, performance tester, performance engineers, system support engineers, for everybody. But in industry, the mind block is, all the way the mind block is, people is always having the mind block, it is only used by the performance testers. No, not like that. It can be used by anybody. It can be used by different team of people. Only thing is how they are going to do, what they are going to do. That is very, very important. If they are clear with, say they are going to do application monitoring, DB monitoring, infrastructure monitoring, real user monitoring, synthetic monitoring, what you are really expecting through that you are going to achieve using these APM tools. Okay, you can do simply, you can do synthetic monitoring, alerting, that's all. You can do real user monitoring, browser level data. You can do DB monitoring. DB, a person can get benefit of it. Like that, you can use the tool in such a way you can get the maximum benefit. Okay, so I'll take a pause here. Anybody have any question till now? Okay, I already mentioned I installed one Linux, Amazon Linux agent into the Linux environment, and I started receiving this information. Anyways, in tomorrow session, anyways, we are going to see in detail about each and everything. Okay, and you can see something related to network, process, all those things we can see. And I also told you yesterday there is a dashboard list available. Instead of, there are two ways. One is you create the dashboard. Another one is they also having the predefined inbuilt dashboards that are there. Okay, say like host count, system disk, system metric, system networking like that. They are also having their own inbuilt things are there. Other than that, you can still do the remaining other things also. You can do it. Say like if I wanted to find is there any system level metric that I wanted to see, because my agent is already running, right? Definitely it started collecting the system level data. So I wanted to see that what is actually load that is coming to my system, CPU that is happening, or IO that are happening, system memory that are happening, network traffic that are happening, because my agent is already running. My agent is running, my data is started collecting. I just wanted to show you today only the tool capability, the look and feel and the tool capability of this Datadog. Okay, don't think like I straight away jump into the ocean. No, we'll start slowly from tomorrow. Each and everything we are going to see from tomorrow. Today I wanted to show you the look and feel, how the Datadog would be looking like, and how the look and feel, what capabilities that are there, what can be done. That view only I wanted to bring in. So this is how your dashboard look and feel will be there. And anyways, we are going to have the remaining capabilities, how the agent installation, how the configuration, everything, how you are going to do and all, we are going to see from tomorrow. But by today, we started this content, like what is APM tool, how it has to be used by different people, and what are all the different tabs and values that are coming in Datadog, what is infrastructure, what are all the technology supported capabilities of Datadog. That is what we really saw today. Okay, so what we can do, so those who are really interested to proceed with this course journey, you can reach out to Kumar sir. This is Kumar sir number, 8019952427. 8019952427. This is Kumar sir number. I am pasting his number in the chat also. You guys can take it. Kumar sir number. Okay, the Kumar sir number. And I'll also paste this course content link to everybody. You guys can take it and then see like what are all the things that are covered. And this is actually, we are going to cover it in 10 hours. Okay, 10 hours, 1 hour per day, which is a weekday session, Monday to Friday. And this is a time slot in which we are going to do the learning. And every video, every hour, we are going to record it. And then we are going to share a YouTube playlist URL. You guys can watch it anytime, because it is lifetime access that we are providing to everybody. So so those who are really interested to proceed with this core journey, you can reach out to Kumar sir. I think probably by today, we are completing our demo sessions by probably from tomorrow. We'll start our regular sessions, regular classes will be there. I expect every one of you will be there for tomorrow session, for our day one session. Thanks everyone for joining this demo session. Thanks for giving me this opportunity to take the session. We will have the similar discussion session from tomorrow. Thanks all. Bye bye.
Thank you.